UCLA is lined up to kick the ball off first, and we are ready to go. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Bowling Green's a team and a program that year in, year out's got 1,000-yard rushers. Sometimes they've got two, and they've got that huge offensive line. And, you know, you get too worried about them, and sometimes you can overlook the fact that you throw the ball.
It's going to be tough today for this defense. I think they're going to have to take some chances and load this line of scrimmage. And, you know, as a play caller for this offense, when you have such a gifted running back, it opens up every aspect of the offense. I mean, the play-action pass with this running game, you get those linebackers and safeties coming up close to the line of scrimmage. It's a great time to really open up and show what you can do as a complete offense. It'll be a challenge.
So they complete that for about 7 yards, and they'll pick up a first down.
Nice protection, a good pass, and even a better catch. You can't ask for much more than that.
It was a great read by the quarterback there to take the snap and throw it quickly to get the first. He fights forward to about the 40.
That makes it 2nd and 8.
Gains his way to midfield.
Maybe after a nice run like that, you try to go up in the air with a play action pass.
Mike 35,
Mike 35. Go,
check, disco Raver, disco Raver.
And he's going to be sacked.
Wow, that is a big hit on the quarterback. That's one of those, as an offensive lineman, when the film study starts to come around, you're going to kind of sink in your chair and just hope they don't call you out, because you're going to get embarrassed on Monday. Now,
they find themselves in a hole here after that sack at 2nd and long. A quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers. Get to that quickly. And he's tackled at the 49. About 6 yards on the play.
It's a decent pickup that time on a well-designed play.
And they've got the dime package in there to try and deal with this 5-receiver look. And a quick throw. And they make the stop around the 44-yard line. Nice gain, but not enough for the first down.
Yeah, that's a nice play there. They did everything right except get enough yards for the first down.
He puts it away, and it's a great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. He's out to the 30. He gets out to about the 37-yard line. He really showed some good speed there.
I'll tell you, no question. When you talk about being able to turn on the jets and leave everybody in the dust, you have to mention this young man. He's got skills, but his speed is what the pro scouts are drooling about.
Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line.
That'll make it 2nd and 7.
Three down. 7's a mic. Mic's set.
Down. Alert.
Oklahoma. Bruin.
Motion.
Scrambling around.
Tight right. Three down. Mike,
they'll
seven.
Spread the field with 5 wide.
Hey.
And down he goes at the 46-yard line. So an empty backfield with 5 wide receivers. He's tackled at the 43-yard line. For a loss.
The defense got a great push and blew that play up well behind the line of scrimmage.
That'll make it 3rd and 13.
They'll line it up again on 3rd down.
Roger. 7's a mic. Mike 7.
Going long. It's going the other way.
I just don't think he saw the defender, and he threw the ball right at him. That's what happens when you focus on one guy. You get tunnel vision.
That was awful. Come on. You got to
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 14. And off up the middle, and he's stuck. Loss of two on the run by the halfback. A complete to the halfback over the middle. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. Brought down at the 43. Offense comes back out, looking to improve from their last effort.
So much in football is about how you respond to adversity. Moving forward after a turnover is a perfect example of that.
The halfback option, good for 7 yards. Brought down around the 48-yard line. Gains his way to the 36-yard line. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. The halfback picks up maybe 5 yards on the draw play.
That brings him second and five.
Here's a screen to the wideout. Tackle at the 31.
No gain on the play. That'll bring up 36.
You're going to see me in your nightmares.
Seven's a Mike. Mike seven.
Check. Right line. Oklahoma.
And they bring him down for a sack on the play.
Loss of 7 yards on the play. That makes it fourth and 12.
They'll call on the field goal
ball,
unit.
The ball.
We've played one. No score here. Even first quarter as we head into quarter number two. UCLA is looking to go up by three. Kicks away. They head to the sideline with nothing to show for that drive. Now this one's scoreless. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. They go to the ground game. Gets to about the 41-yard line. Taken down at the 44-yard line. So they get about three on the draw.
That makes it 33.
Makes the first down catch. He's taken down at the 46.
Gain of 10 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
Goes down quickly.
Call it a gain of 6 yards. That will make it second and four.
Makes it out to about the 29.
That's a gain of 11 on the play. First down.
If these defenders continue to exploit the O-line like that, it's going to be a long day for this running back.
From the 31-yard line, it's second down. They go to the screen here, and the halfback's got it. They'll bring him down around the 23-yard line.
Well, the defense has to be very frustrated there. They did everything. They got to the quarterback. In fact, it looked like they had a chance to bring him down for the sack, but somehow he's able to throw the ball away.
So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for three. Bowling Green could take the lead with this field goal. It's up, and it is good. They line up to kick this one away. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Gains his way to the 33-yard line.
Guys have the capability to gain solid, consistent yardage. They have to regroup, come out a bit more motivated next time.
Third and five situation. Ball on their own 30. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Tackle made at about the 47-yard line.
He showed some excellent moves out there, more than you usually expect from a tight end. That was a big gain, and this offense keeps humming along.
Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. He gets out to about the 48-yard line. Makes it out to about the 40.
Especially in the secondary, really get after it and can make life hard for the play callers on the other side of the ball.
From the 40-yard line, it's second down. Run right and hit in the backfield.
From a defensive coordinator standpoint, it can really help out your scheme when you get excellent run support by the corner.
This is the eighth play of this drive. Boy, was he drilled as he let go of that football.
Yeah, he's going to feel that one tomorrow.
They'll line it up for a very long field goal attempt. UCLA can tie it up here with this kick. He gets it up, and it's long enough, and it's good.
You know, I was wondering if he's going to get a chance to kick one of those. We saw him warming up from 60 yards before the game.
3-3 tie. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Well, it's always fun to be part of a defensive battle, and that's certainly what we have right now.
Yeah, give credit to both of these defenses. I mean, they're playing with a lot of energy, and I think they're doing a nice job up front at the line of scrimmage. And at this point, they're not giving either of these offenses a chance to make a play.
You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. And he's hit immediately. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
Second down, 8 yards to go. Ball on the 27-yard line. That's a great tackle at the 19.
Sometimes it's just a relentless pass rush that results in a sack. That's what happened there.
He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. So they try to fool him with the run, but the defense was all over him.
Great job here by the defense to penetrate the offensive line and get to the ball carrier before he got too many yards.
It's away, and it's a booming punt. They'll bring him down at the 41-yard line. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. He's under some heat. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch. From the 43-yard line, first down. Just throws this one away.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
He scrambled. And he's tackled at the 39. Completes it, but he can't shake the defense. And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down. You don't need three guesses to figure out what they're going to run right here on fourth and short.
Blue 19! Blue 19!
Makes it to the 32-yard line. He's going to try and scramble. And they make the stop at the 25. Five wide. Quick throw to the tight end. And down he goes around the 10-yard line.
I think he was going to go to his tight end the whole way, but the defense didn't expect it. Sometimes those big guys can fool defenders into thinking they're blocking.
He gets it up, and the field goal is good. Folks, that's the end of the first half, and this game's getting interesting. The Bruins with a 3-point lead.
We played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. The Bruins find themselves in an unexpected battle, to say the least. And this is why Coach flipped out this week, trying to get the attention of his team, and it didn't work.
No, it didn't work. And coaches flip out for different reasons. And they usually have a plan in their head and why they do it, and they're usually trying to get their guys to feel a certain way or, you know, take something a little bit more serious. It didn't work. It didn't take. The message didn't take, and these guys didn't come out ready to play, and now all of a sudden you look and you're in a ball game. And that's
the
problem.
So what do you do about it now? So what do you do?
Well, now you come in the locker room and you go, okay, guys, you're dumb. You didn't listen to me. You didn't want to know the truth that you could lose to these guys. And now you're in a dogfight the whole second half. Let's come out. Let's put a statement up. Let's do what you're capable of doing because you're way better than this team. It's pretty simple.
I can only hope that Nessler and Herb Street will bring the same type of intensity to their call of the second half that David and I have brought to the halftime show. Of course, they always do. That's it for us here in the studio. Time to get you back out to the guys for the second half.
Very close game now as we start the second half. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. So we're just about ready to return to action. UCLA is up by 3. Fires it out. And he's leveled at the 31-yard line.
Wow. If the basketball coach is watching, he might want to give this guy a call. That is excellent vertical.
Up the middle for a nice game.
Makes the tackle. Call it a gain of 4 yards. That'll bring up third and inches.
Mike seven.
Check three. Makes it out to about the 49. Drill at the 42-yard line. They go with a run, and that'll be a gain of 9. Here he goes. Makes it to the 34. Around the 22-yard line. It's first and 10. Ball on the 22. They go with a runner. He's taken down behind the line. And the linebacker comes up and makes a big stop.
This is textbook. This is how you're supposed to play against the run.
Zips it to the back. Brought down at the 16. UCLA holds a field goal lead. Nice run, and he's brought down. He hits him hard at the 3.
That's good.
Get off the field.
That'll bring up second and 3.
Hey!
Check three! Touchdown, Bruins!
This kid is a really reliable weapon. You definitely want the football in his hands near the end zone, and he showed you why right there.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. It was an 11-play, 75-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Big opening. He's to the 40. He gets to about the 41-yard line. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, and that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
He fights forward to about the 43.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards. That makes it second and 8.
Check three.
He gets it out to about the 47-yard line.
Gain of 10 yards. First down.
Fires quickly, and he's got his man. Tackle at the 46-yard line.
Number 2, the tackle at the 46-yard line. That brings up second and 9.
Check three.
He steps out right around the 42-yard line.
Check.
throw incomplete. Blotted his receiver.
Well, he must have hurried there because his receiver was wide open. There was no need to rush that one at all.
The punting team's got to give their kicker some time. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
It's early in this game, so the defense can still have an opportunity to make some adjustments. But if things don't turn around in a hurry, it's really going to start to affect the psyche of that defensive line.
Nice catch, first down, and he's knocked out. A quarterback in the gun with five receivers. Gains his way to the 46-yard line. And he's taken down around the 44-yard line. They'll spread the field with five wide. Gains his way to the 29-yard line. He's at the 20. He makes his way to about the 18. From the 18-yard line, it's first down. Now he tries to buy some time. He's taken down at the 8-yard line. Forward to about the 7. They'll bring him down right around the 4-yard line.
That's a gain of 3 on the play. That brings him second and goal.
Gets rid of this one. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
It's third and goal, and they're about 4 yards out. And he tackles him hard at the 8.
You've got to admire the intensity that these linebackers bring to the table. As soon as he saw it was staying on the ground, he made a beeline for the ball carrier.
Kick is up, and it's through the uprights. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. UCLA's continuing to play extremely tough defense. This has been impressive.
It's just been impressive to watch them play with such an attitude, almost a chip on their shoulder with the energy that they're playing with. And I think it's going to require that kind of effort to be able to win this game.
Their last drive ended in a punt, so this quarterback's going to be looking for something better on this drive.
Down two possessions, this offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
Quick pass. Well, this turned out to be a pretty good ball game, and we've got one quarter to go. 16-3, Bruins. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number 4. He gets rid of this one. Third down and 6 yards to go. Ball on the 29. Nice pitch and catch for the first down. Tackle made
right around the 44-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Got it. Complete. He's out of bounds.
That's good for a game of 19 yards. First down.
35's the mic. Let's go. Let's get this ball back for the offense. Let's go.
They bring him down. They get to the quarterback and end that play before it even got started.
This young man didn't even have a chance to make something happen. It's tough to find your receivers when the defense is in your face like that.
So the sack makes this a second and long. To his tight end, nothing doing.
I'm not so sure he made the best decision that time. That was a pretty tight area he was trying to throw that one into.
Flips it middle to the running back. And he's tackled right around the 46-yard line. Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down. He sails it long. He goes up and gets it. And he scores. Touchdown.
The wideout here truly knows what he has to do to contribute to make his team successful.
They rolled the dice and went for it on fourth, and I'm sure they're happy with the result. And he tacks on the extra point. It was an 8-play, 74-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
Brad, how about the guys up front? The offensive line giving the quarterback plenty of time to be able to read the defense and make the right throw.
Excellent kick. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. UCLA is up by 6. They bring him down in the backfield. Nowhere to go for the halfback. That's a loss of one.
That'll bring up second and 11.
Here's a run. He's gobbled up in the backfield.
That's a loss of 1 yard on the play.
I can't believe
that
you
brings up third and 12.
Seven's a mark. Jack.
And they got him.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. Don't be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
So no luck on that drive as they go 3 and out. After the sack, it's now 4th and long. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. Tackle made at midfield. Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. And he's going to come up with a sack. A touchdown would give him the lead here in the fourth, but that'll be hard to come by if this offensive line can't get it done.
This is where we find out who wants it more.
Second down, and they've got 15 for the first down. Ball on their own 45. Brought down immediately. About 4 yards on that play.
He took what the defense gave him that time, which is okay. It keeps the yards to go a little bit more manageable.
And he's tackled right away.
First down.
Just under 3 to go in regulation. they push him out.
Right around the 32-yard line.
That'll make it second and four.
They bring the quarterback down.
That makes it 3rd and 15.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 28.
Stays in bounds and made a nice catch. So the referee initially calls it a catch, but we'll have a chance to take a second look at it and determine if he really was in bounds when he caught the ball.
Well, the side judge was standing right there, so I'd be surprised if he missed that call.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
So after some discussion, the call on the field stands. From the 23-yard line, first down.
Just shows you that you don't need to be sacking the quarterback to disrupt the passing game.
To get back in this game here in the fourth, this third and goal is vital. Just under 2 minutes in the game. Great pressure on the quarterback forced that incompletion.
Boy, they really pounded him on that throw.
Touchdown, and we're all tied up. They'll try to tack on the extra point that will take the lead. Here's the call from the
delay
referee.
Game. Offense.
And he converts the extra point. A 10-play, 50-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
This quarterback has really demonstrated a tremendous amount of ability and leadership today. I'd be very surprised if he didn't continue to play well.
This one's going to be down to the end zone for a touchback. The Bruins have played poorly all day long. That really doesn't matter right now.
They've played sloppy. They're not going to be happy when they go back and look at the film on Monday. But with all that being said, they still have a chance to win this game. And at the end of the day, that's all that matters, is trying to get that W.
Just under two to go in the game. He scrambled. And down he goes around the 31-yard line. He must not have seen anybody open on that play.
Nobody open downfield, but he's got to be careful. I like his toughness, but those kind of hits are going to take a toll on him eventually.
Got his man. Can't tack on any yardage. They'll line up with five wide receivers. He makes his way to about the 48. Quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation. Looking for his man, incomplete.
Number seven, the intended receiver on the play.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on their own 48.
Larry. Here we go, watch
Quick throw. He's at the 40. Receiver, and they make the stop at the 19-yard line. And this play is number 8 on the drive. They run it left. Nice run to the outside. UCLA is going to have to use their second time out of the half. From the 14-yard line. It's second down. And he's tackled after positive yardage. They come out on an empty backfield. Slings it out there. Tight end's got another one. Dig deep to score here that late in the fourth quarter and come from behind. And now the question is, can their defense dig in and win it for them? So the offense is going to go for two.
You're not ready. Mike seven. Mike seven.
Five wide.
Set. 10-19.
Watch the slam.
Motion, motion.
Now he's scrambling. He's got the two. And that should do it. Our final tally in this one, 24-17, Bruin. Thanks for joining us for another game of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk and everyone here at EA Sports, Brad Nussler saying goodbye, and we'll see you next time.